See, power manifestation is just reassuring your own being that higher cognitions have become already part of you. So come on, we can play with the higher cognitions as lifestyle. We can play the higher cognitions. We can marry higher cognitions. We can make decisions based on higher cognitions. That is what is power manifestation. Nothing else. I can trust this fellow. Yes. So, having that cool feeling with the higher cognitions, higher conclusions is power manifestation. What you understood?
Basically, that whatever we are, when we see that the consciousness is existing, without any of our own beliefs or anything coming in between, when we have the cognition as it is, and just trust that cognition, will immediately manifest any power.
That's all. Now you tell what all powers you will manifest now. No, your cognition now, na? Now what I said is no more my cognition. When it becomes yours, your cognition. See, if I have given that bonda to you, it is your bonda now. Whether you are going to eat or push it into your ears or the nose or share it with others is your decision. Come on. What all powers you want to manifest? It's your freedom now. Come. Come to the front. Now you don't have to have that overwhelming or fear or need to prove or any of that. Understand? You, come on, tell.
All the powers that Swamiji has given until now. Like, including, he's also initiated into flying and into like the levitation and having the consciousness over the matter and then ability to manifest anything we want at any time. And just by, like, the powers of healing of the diseases should be used for the power of healing the incompletions.
Oh, okay. So then start manifesting. What are you supposed to do to manifest?
Make a trusted cognition.
And then start doing it. Now, what I am saying, play with yourself. Yes. If this is what is, then let me start doing this. How I know I am doing this? Let me define what, how. So let me prove to me. Let me prove to my surroundings. Start.
Swamiji, but like it's a cognition that consciousness can happen and like we just need to trust it. But logically, like, for example, the power of flying, logically has never seen it. So how to directly trust it that it is possible or how
what I am saying then, you why don't you ask this question and answer? You answer and you do it. Why don't you play with it? So then consciousness is powerful or logic is powerful?
Consciousness.
Then?
So we just need to trust it and start.
No. You come to the conclusion. You don't need to answer me. You come to the conclusion which is going to make you do it and manifest it. If you are not able to come to the conclusion, struggle with it. Or do what needs to be done with it. Come on, you answer.
So just start doing it.
So what all you already manifested? So many things you manifested. Then why but comes here? Even before manifesting, that also but came, na? But came, but you did not budge for the but. So the but has lost its but effect. Where all now you are going to break your butt effect?
Like any power you give, like if you initiate into any power, then instead of budging for any of the self-doubts that come up, just trust the cognition and immediately manifest.
Okay. Now, what all powers you want, you tell.
To fly and materialization in higher levels and disappear and appear and manifest anything that others want.
Tathastu. Now I give you. Start manifesting. Do you understand when I say now I give you, it is given?
Yes.
Do you see? The moment I held that power thought currents into the system and pushed it into you?
Yes.
Then start manifesting now. Many times you jumped the butts and manifested powers. So jumping the butt is not something new for you. Jump the next butt. Come on, you come. Let her be jumping the her butts. You come. Before everyone gathers back, I'll make you guys jump your butts. Come on. You heard whole thing. Now what do you want? Come on. What do you want?
Causing anybody's reality, no matter what obstacle they have.
Then?
And the second thing is, like Raghupati Yogi, even by sound, anything, any matter should be able to move.
Then?
Be able to see all the devas and devis.
Then?
Materialization, teleportation on the physical body.
Then?
Fly and like disappear into thin air.
Then?
That's all, Swamiji.
Tathas, start manifesting.
Yes, Swamiji.
You don't even have buts, so simply start manifesting.
Okay, Swamiji.
Now manifest and show. It is just manifestation now. What do you want to manifest and what do you want to play with? Play. Once you are able to do, show. That's all. Everything will look like child play till it is demonstrated, because it is mystery school. Understand? An onlooker will go crazy. Insider will go crazy. This whole scene, an outsider will go crazy. What is going on? That girl is telling, I want to fly, and this fellow is telling, Tathastu. You guys don't have to wait. Who will start flying first? You can be first. It's not required. See, for the first power only, you need to wait. Is it true or not? For the second power, you don't need to wait for the other person to manifest. You know it is true. Over. The logic of third eye, logic of flying is one and the same. If you crack the code of the third eye, then you know flying. Understand? You know how to get something from your mom, na? Huh? Whether it is one jewelry or one sari, logic is same. You know what you should tell for her to give. That's it. Same thing. Logic of power manifestation, logic of building the shed is different. But the logic of third eye and the logic of flying is one and the same. If I ask you to build this shed only, you should think, oh God, I do not know what weight pole I should put it. I do not know how to put this truss. It's a new logic. Now that also can be done by power, downloading the whole construction logic and downloading the whole inspiring the labors and getting them to work logic. Then downloading, putting it together and making it happen. That also can be done by power. That is different level. Now, what you asked and what you already manifested is same logic. You just have to start playing. Nothing else. The super logic of power manifestation is strategic existence of you. Powers, matter, does not have border, which is actual, factual and real. All the balasins, you guys can pick up the mic and declare what power you are going to manifest and start manifesting. Now you guys have to start the show. It's a show time now. All the balasins, are you guys clear about what you heard now? Come on, all you guys start manifesting. You guys are going to set the trend for them to manifest now. Not the standard, just trend. Because they are going to cross you guys now. They are not going to set the standard, they are only going to set the trend. Nobody can set a standard. Standard will always be upgraded. Actually, now the potatoes are boiling. Who wants to pick up the mic? Start.
Swamiji, I want to manifest the power of making anybody have a right cognition inside them. Whatever cognition I want to manifest inside them, they should manifest that power. And I should be able to materialize and teleport myself and anything.
Do you see the color went from my mouth to his head? Not able to grasp, huh? Because you are an artist, your eyes can catch colors. Do you know your eyes can actually catch auras? Means the colors around the persons. Have you started ever seeing colors around the persons? You'll be able to see it. That's actually one of the power. You can, just by seeing the person, you can know the intention and his existence. Is life positive or life negative and all that.
And every time, Swamiji should manifest through this body.
done. Start manifesting now and show. Only if it becomes undoubtable in others, it will become undoubtable in you. Because others have become very much part of you. People around you have become very much part of you. You see many times you through others' eyes. Now start. Who wants the mic next?
Swamiji, first make anyone come to a higher conclusion and have a higher cognition about life. Next, want to be able to like move through any dimension and see anything. Want to be able to teleport and be at different places at once.
Tathast.
Only Swamiji should manifest.
Done. Now start manifesting.
Swamiji, first power of expanding the capacity of the lungs to hold the air so I can hold the breath for more than 30 minutes to 1 hour.
Done.
Second, to materialize solid objects and teleport them to different places.
Done.
And next, Swamiji, just by the stare of the third eye, the other person should just immediately get healed by any problem that they have.
So be it. Done. Now manifest. What you ask, you should manifest now.
Swamiji, anybody here who comes, so they should have a cognitive shift. They should write any problem that they have, something that they are stuck with, they'll write in a paper and they'll keep. So without seeing it, Nityananda should be able to see the problem through the third eye, show them the powerful cognition that they can manifest in the Krishna Shila, and within 21 minutes, that without verbalizing anything, that powerful cognition should happen to them and they should tell.
Done.
And also, Nityananda should be able to crack people's password, whoever posts any abusive comments or anything. So within 11 minutes, the password should just appear and should be able to crack it in.
Done.
And Nityananda wants the joy that happens when Nityananda remembers Swamiji. Anybody who comes with physical problem or any mental incompletions or anything, without any verbalization, just in the Krishna Shila, showing or entangling them with the joy that happens, they should start saying the solution on their own and they should walk out of that problem.
Done. Manifest now.